I'll come back on Monday. Because I have to control myself. I mean, I'll come back doing videos on Monday. I have this little thing I've been starting to do, and I totally fucked it up. I wait till my last featured video goes up to at least 108 views, and then I go on. I have to control myself because I can go on and on and on and on and on. You see, I'm not trying to shove any self-limiting dogma down anyone's throat. But damn it, I also have something to say. People talk about 2012, right? But to me, this whole life, this ephemeral life, is 2012. If you understand what I mean by that. Okay, I'm gonna have to let Frida out, because if not, she's gonna continue barking. Hold on. She likes to play this game where she barks to go out and let her out, and then she barks to come back in, so then she barks to go out, and she keeps on doing this to me, yanking my chain. But anyway. I'll be communicating with some beautiful people that I've met on Facebook. I don't consider the cyber world unreal. It's another world. It's another world. And what is anyone doing in a social network but communicating with conscious beings, with other conscious beings? And it really doesn't even matter whether you know them completely or not. Because you can go to a bar, you can go to a club, you can go to a restaurant, you can go to a bookstore. And just because you talk to someone face to face does not mean that you know them. Just see. You may live with someone for years and not really know them. Every morning, right? Anna and I have talks under the gazebo outside. And the spirit just flows. I'm amazed at the things that come out of her and out of me. Many times, and this has been my experience, I learn from the things that issue forth out of my own mouth. I am the guru that says that we are all gurus. We are all here to teach and help one another. But this help appears in so many different ways. Not in any limiting way. So I am a catalyst. Anna is developing her latent psychic and mediumistic abilities. such an extent that frankly, she pisses me off. Huh. You see, I don't have to know everything to be what and who I am. A person doesn't have to be my godchild, quote unquote, to benefit from what I have to share. I am not on this trip that most people think from time to time that I'm on. Excuse the term, but my love pervades everywhere. Yes, even unto my foes, unto those that wish to attack me, my love goes to them. Even if I knock you out, I'll probably be the first, in fact, I know, I'll be the first one to try to heal you. Well, maybe. But I will not harbor hate. Anger, yes. Not even harbor. Express it. But I don't really know the meaning of hate. So I told Anna, so you see, you're developing these things that are already inside of you. Seeds that were just about to blossom, right? Things that I can't even do so much. Well, sometimes they come and go. Because of our communication. You see? So, I don't have to be everything and know everything. I can accept you. Why am I seen as this egomaniac? Because I am a Baba of an ancient lineage. Why must you put me in this conceptual box that I do not belong in? I will continually just burst out of that box. Because I have seen something. I have felt something. I know something. And this something is so, so great, so all-encompassing, that I am like this ancient tale in the Bhagavatam that says, Ananta Sheshanaga. Ananta means unlimited, endless. Shesha has two meanings. Shesha means head. Shesha also means that which remains after all is said and done. Naga has two meanings. Naga means bare, naked. Naga also implies serpent. The serpent has always been a symbol of wisdom. So, Ananta Shesha Naga, described many times as the thousand-headed snake, but this is a symbol. Really, it means the unlimited heads of the pure ego manifestation of consciousness. And it is said that Ananta, with his endless heads and endless mouths, never tires of glorifying, of celebrating, of describing the endless, ecstatic and transcendental pastimes of the transcendental person dwelling within each and every one of us and beyond us. People do not understand this term. God is a transcendental person. They freeze this do not realize. Look, the words. Transformation. Huh? Transportation. Huh? Trans implies movement. Yeah? Movement. This is what trans implies. Huh? So, this absolute, excuse the word, because what is absolute? Well, what is absolute is the self. The self, in my estimation, is the absolute equation. So terribly simple, yet we constantly are failing to see it. So, technically, I am the head. Oba can mean chief, Oba can mean king. But I am not like any other Oba I've seen so far, anyway. Because I am not trying to lord over anyone. To me, I like to try to aspire to be Oba of Prem, which is a divine love that is beyond conception and even goes beyond this notion of even divine love. Magic. Even beyond this. How to express this? I don't know. But I try. Because I know that my overship is not even mine, not even limited to me. No. Because I have seen something. I have felt something, and I know this something, and I must share this. I must. Whether you consider that I am crazy or anything you might want to say. I'm always like this. I don't need to be in front of a green light to be this way. Ask anyone that knows me, and they will tell you the same. They will say that Narayan, that Shiva head, he does not change. How to explain? This is why I continue. We are all here to bring something to the table. So I am also here. This is a medium, a conscious medium. Okay? The music will cut off. I will work after the book on the law on this series on Orisha and what Orisha means and the history thereof. I hope my friends and some of you will benefit from my take on this. From my heart to yours.